Morning, everybody. Welcome to Saturday edition of Plumbing with Tim. Today we're in the old Cherokee. We're going to head north here a little ways to the largest lake in Brevard County and show you how we get our water supply to this area. So won't you join me? Okay, so we've arrived here in beautiful Lake Washington, Brevard County's largest freshwater lake that is also a part of the St. John's River Water Management. You've seen me put other videos about this area and stuff. This right here is where plumbing really starts in our community, is where we get our freshwater supply for a good share of our community, as well as the wastewater treatment plant. So let's check it out. Now, I've lived out in this area a good share of my life, and sad to say, this is the first time I've ever been out here. There's actually a park located here at the Lake Washington, and it's absolutely loaded with recreation. Airboats, there's pavilions out here for major parties and stuff, and this is a really cool spot. This Lake Washington is the lifeblood of this community. This is where every bit of plumbing in this entire area begins. Now, last week you saw me put a video out on water towers and stuff. Well, those water towers have to get water supply from somewhere, and in this general area, it's right here at Lake Washington, and this is where they had the large diesel pumps that draw the water out of this lake, fresh water from the St. John's River Water Management, and supplies it to these water towers for our community. Now, this time of year here in Florida, we're in the middle of what's called the hurricane season. So my buddy Matt, the old Florida boy from Florida Boy Survival, gave me this location, and he's going to be putting out a video here soon about hurricane preparedness and readiness. Now, there's no way for me to actually stand next to where these pumps are. It's in a restricted area. So we're going to cheat a little bit and take the drone up in the air and go take a look over in that direction. You might ask yourself, what the heck has this got to do with plumbing? Area? Everything. Last year here in this county, we had Hurricane Irma came through here and dumped such a massive amount of water that it caused problems with the water treatment plants here in the area. It took up to 6 months, even longer, for some of the low-lying areas around here to recede those waters from that hurricane. Lake Washington, where I'm at, where we pump the water for our communities and stuff, they were forced after the hurricane to actually restrict the amount of water that was coming into the communities because of the amount of water going out in wastewater. They weren't able to keep up with it. The amount was so high that the people in this area for a good month or month and a half, 2 months were restricted on the water flow at their homes. There you guys have it. Hey, remember, my buddy Matt, the old Florida boy from Florida Boy Survival, will be putting out a video here soon. Go over and check out his channel, Florida Boy Survival, on hurricane preparedness and readiness, seeing that we're right here in the middle of hurricane season, the most fun time of the year here down in Florida. Remember, all municipalities have this type of system to regulate water flow as well as wastewater. Here in Florida, it's on more of a dynamic scale because we deal with hurricanes. So I'd love to hear about your community and how you guys receive water and how the wastewater is treated and the restrictions on water. And don't forget to drop down and hit the subscribe button, give me a like and a thumbs up, share it with friends. Till next time, let's all stay safe, keep plumbing.